Hey, everybody. Hey, everybody. Hey, everybody. Chuck G here. Sorry you're going to listen to me chomping on this cough drop here. Hold on, I gotta eat this thing. Hold on. Okay, that was yummy. That was yummy. So how's everybody doing today? I hope well. I'm doing moderately well myself. I want to apologize for last night, not streaming last night. Something that just didn't happen. I haven't been feeling well. I've been a little under the weather health-wise. Been a little busy. And okay, so we are going strong. Yay for me. I've been a little under the weather. My voice is still a little DJ-ish. Let me check these levels again, because I'm worried I'm getting... Nah, it's not. I'm okay. Right. I always worry that I'm getting some clipping and that you know, what I hear in my in-ear monitors is not necessarily what you all are hearing. And, you know, it's a fight with the little mixing board that I have to get all of that going. So, I was not able to stream last night and I really apologize. I want to try to keep to a schedule. That's the best way to keep fans and the best way to keep listeners is to stream when you say you're going to stream. And I didn't do that last night. So that's my bad. I am going to do one today. Friday is not a day I normally stream. Normally I'm performing on Fridays. I'm usually away. Like next week I'll be away. I'll be away actually a good part of next week, Wednesday through Sunday. And so, you know, a lot of times I'm away playing and performing or doing this, that, or what have you. So I try not to stream on, you know, over the weekend, of course, you know, except for Sunday. I'm going to amend my schedule. And we're going to be streaming Sunday afternoons now. And that's going to be Sunday circa 4 p.m., I think, Eastern time. I'm on the East Coast. I am in Atlanta, Georgia, and we're going to be streaming in the afternoon on Sunday instead of in the evening. I talked about it on my stream on Tuesday about how that just doesn't work for me. Schedule-wise, Sunday night, there's too much chaos in my house. You know, this is a young person's game. And when I say young person's game, I mean, it's a young person's game, a young person who lives by him or herself, without, you know, quote unquote, real life hassles getting in the way. And while I don't consider my children, a hassle in any way, shape or form, they are still my children. And they're actually not really even my children. They're my stepchildren, but, I treat them as if they were my children because they are that important. I love them both very, very much, and I'm always proud of what they do. They're two great kids, but they make a lot of ruckus because one is in high school and the other one's going to be in high school soon. I've got a 7th grader and a 10th grader. So Sunday night is the night that they go back and forth between houses. So they're over at their father's this week, which is nice because they've been off all week this week, so they haven't been bothering me while I'm not feeling well. So, I'm sorry. There's going to be a little bit of that in here. I have been sick for a while, actually, since about Saturday afternoon, Sunday. I played a concert in Huntsville, Alabama, Saturday night last week, and came home sick, and was pretty sick. You know, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. I streamed anyway on Tuesday. Not my best effort, but went ahead and did it anyway. And I'm going to go ahead and do it today, even though I'm not 100%. I am feeling a lot better, but I don't know about you, but like when I got older, and when I say older, I mean out of my 20s, I noticed that when I get sick, when I get a cold, those things linger a lot longer when you're an adult. And I think it has to do, I think the mental side of it is more of what we're talking about here. So like mentally, when I get sick, when I get a cold, it's very difficult for me to stay motivated to do things, because I just don't feel good and I'm just tired. I'm worn down. So I don't want to do stuff. And, you know, and that's kind of what happened yesterday. I wasn't feeling great. You know, my wife got home from work. We had dinner and I was like, hey, look, I want to stream around 7. So I'm going to go do this thing. And then, you know, then I got on the couch and I was eating dinner and we were watching a show and we're trying to watch, I've already seen it, Daredevil, okay, on Netflix before it goes away. You know, she was intrigued by Daredevil's, Spider-Man spoilers. She was very intrigued by Matthew Murdock's brief cameo in the Spider-Man movie, Daredevil being one of my favorite comic books that I've read since I was very young. I was like, I just cheesed out. I was like completely fangirled over. I was like, oh my God, it's Matt Murdock. And then he catches this brick, you know, and I was like, oh my God, it's Daredevil too. So that was my fangirl moment in Spider-Man Far From Home or Can't Go Home or No Way Home, whatever it was. So, we're trying to watch that. We're trying to watch, Daredevil. We finished the first 2 seasons of Daredevil and then we found out that it's leaving Netflix soon. Like, you know, in a week and a half. So now we're in Defenders. I did not watch Jessica Jones. I did not watch, you know, the Luke Cage or the Iron Fist or any of that stuff. I read the comic books when I was a kid. I just wasn't, you know, the Iron Fist I was kind of into, but the show, I caught a little bit of it. It just wasn't very good. You know, Luke Cage, I don't know. You know, I liked Power Man and Iron Fist. They had their own comic book together when in the 70s and 80s when I was reading a lot of comics. And I followed it and I watched it and it was cool. But, you know, I didn't get dig on the show because I kind of stopped reading comic books in the late 90s and 2000s and just kind of haven't been following it there. But, you know, at the risk of derailing this stream from a violin stream into a comic book stream... you know, the point I'm getting at is we're trying to watch all this stuff before it goes away. So, yeah, I just got too comfortable and like, I couldn't get up. I couldn't do it. But I'm doing it today and we're going to go again on Sunday afternoon. We're going to go again on Tuesday next week, Tuesday night, I think, instead of Tuesday day. I don't know. We'll see. I'll get this schedule thing down as we go. So what are we doing today? What are we doing today? Well, today we're doing some new music. I am always adding music. I spent the last few days adding a bunch more music that I really enjoy. Kind of music that just sort of fell in my lap. Like I want to, you know, not the Canon in D, which is first, of course. You know, the Canon, we all know the Canon. But I found a nice backing track for it, and I want to play it. I personally like the Canon. The Taco Bell Canon, or Taco Bell Canon, as we call it. We're so funny. The Canon is actually quite an ingenious bit of writing, because all it is row, row, row your boat. You know, it's the same 4 bars repeated over and over again. Well, not the same 4, but for the cello part, it's the same 4 bars. You know, which there's a great YouTube video, a comedian, he plays guitar. He does a thing about the Taco Bell Canon. And the chord structure of the canon is used in like every rock and roll song ever. So it's a great watch. You should check it out. It's pretty old, but check it out. Anyways, it's actually 2 bar phrases here. So we have 2 bars, 2 bars, 2 bars, 2 bars. And every 2 bars, the next voice comes in. There are 3 voices altogether. I'll be playing the first voice, you know, duh. And so that, you know, it's really interesting the way that I'm playing different music and the other voices are playing the same music I had already played just 2 bars later, and it all fits and it's all beautiful. It's a really interesting way. It's a great compositional technique if you are trying to work on being a composer. You know, it's just, it's a really interesting form of music to write in. I like the Canon. I think it's pretty. I think it's nice. It's actually quite easy to play. It's in a terrific key for violin. So I'm going to start with it. It's about 6.5 minutes long. Just give you some nice, easy Baroque background music to chill to. And then we're going to break into some new music that I put in, you know, some Smith, Sting. I got a couple of three Sting songs in there, some Duran Duran. I'm going to try, I have a favorite song of mine that I can't find any sheet music to, but I did find a backing track to that I like, so we're going to try to fake through that. I'll talk about that later on. If you're popping in and you want to say hi in the chat, please do. Song suggestions. I always want song suggestions. So if you want to hear something from me next week, tomorrow, whenever it is, you know, pop it in the chat, send me a DM. I'm happy to do it. Check me out on Instagram. Check me out on Facebook, Chuck G Violin everywhere. And let's enjoy the Canon. Harpsichord in my music room here. I'm trying to play this in a Baroque style, which means no vibrato.
part so pretty.
All right. Well, we all know what that was. That was the Canon in D. I enjoy playing that piece. I'd play it again right now if you asked me. But I'm not gonna. I like that piece very, very much. As you can see now, we got in the queue. We got a few things going. And what we don't have is a lot of light on me. And I need to fix that. So my lighting is a no bueno. Come light to me. I gotta get that out in front of me a little bit better, but my setup still here is a work in progress. This whole room, this is where I teach my violin lessons and where I practice, but it is also the gaming room where the Xbox is and where the children and I will from time to time play the video games, although I do most of my gaming on my desktop computer, which is in the other room. There are a few games that are not available on PC that I go ahead and play on Xbox, like MLB The Show. New one coming out pretty soon if they can figure out their labor issues in baseball. So what are we doing next? Well, we got some Smiths. There's always Smiths. I like the Smiths. This is a band that I enjoyed in high school. And when I was in high school, I was all about, oh, give me all the angsty, you know, the angsty stuff. You know, I wanted to listen to, you know, my favorite piece in the world when I was in high school was the Sixth Symphony of Tchaikovsky, because it's so dark and sad. And you know, I was an angsty teenager, and I wanted to hear angsty music. So the Smiths music, I don't know what it is. I mean, the music itself is usually what draws me into liking or not liking a band. And the Smiths music is pretty good. I think the song I heard first that I love, of course, is the Please, 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 Can't I Get What I Want? Featured in the Ferris Bueller soundtrack. And that's a great song. I played that on stream before. For this stream, we're going to play This Charming Man by the Smiths. And, of course, the other thing that's interesting about the Smiths is you also have to kind of separate. You kind of have to separate the people, you have to separate the politics from the actor. You have to separate the opinions from the musician or what have you. And Morrissey through the years has not been a swell guy, to put it mildly. you know, I love his music, and I like his solo music. And I've loved the Smiths since I was 15 years old, but I just, you know, like his overwhelming, a lot of the things he does are well-intentioned, obviously, you know, being, you know, complete, you know, vegan and not wanting to torture animals. There's nothing wrong with that at all. It's just, you know, like anything, when you take it to fanatical extremes, then the original message gets lost. So, plus he's also like, he cancels concerts right and left, and he's just kind of a temperamental a-hole. That being said, I don't want to get on a thing about Morrissey, but yeah, the Smiths music is really interesting. The words, of course, are also very interesting. Some of the songs, I mean, they could be Weird Al songs for all I know. You know, the language in these songs, not the language, you know, the you know, so downtrodden and so over the top melodramatic that it almost is a satire of itself. So, anyways, let's play some Smiths. And let's see if this works. Again, trying out some new music. There it is. Hit it. Okay, that works. It's a little circular for a song, though. And the music that I have doesn't quite exactly get back around. But it almost works. Good stuff. Morrissey and Marr, the Smiths. Okay, as I flop sweat my way through this set here. Oh, I love this song. Okay. Obviously, We know Sting. We know Sting from his Police days. And has gone on to have, you know, obviously he is rock and roll, you know, royalty. I mean, the guy is amazing. He's a terrific songwriter. You know, a perfectionist in the studio, and his music shows it. You know, I've heard stories. I don't know for sure because I've never worked with him, but I've heard stories about how difficult he is to work with. But, you know, I believe those stories stem from him being completely, again, a perfectionist in the studio. Paul McCartney was like that. But the music shows it. And his songs are well-crafted, and his music is fun. Some of it's not fun. Some of it's more fun than others. This song is fun. This is a song called Englishman in New York, which came out a long time ago. I mean, this is back from like the 80s. Yeah, the copyright on this music that I have is 87. It's from his, I believe, second solo album. And, you know, it's a cute song. He would write in a lot of different styles. You know, his songwriting is never been about one set style of music. And, you know, this obviously is a little more jazz based. So is another song we're going to play later on called 7 Days, which is actually in an odd meter, which is in a 5 meter. So we'll get to that in a minute. But, you know, Englishman in New York is a lot of fun because it just, you know, it's a little more jazzy song. It actually kind of does the whole New York thing. It I don't know if these backing tracks that I have are going to break it down like it does later on, you know, kind of to show the more hip-hoppy type of New York that Sting is talking about. Oh, that's some cold coffee. I don't like cold coffee. I don't like iced coffee either. I don't know. Coffee is meant to be drank warm. Certainly hot. Hot or warm. Kind of room temperature the way it is now is no bueno. So I'm going to give this a try again. These were all first goes on all of these. I haven't played any of these yet. I just found some music and I found some backing tracks and I threw them in the thing. And so we're going to kind of see what shakes loose today. This is Englishman in New York, written by Gordon Sumner, otherwise known as Sting. Let's see how it goes. Oh no, it's under S for Sting. Tee hee. Or is it? I know it's in here because I put it in here. That's really weird. Like, I actually played a little of it yesterday. Is it under A for an Englishman? No. Wow. There's 7 days. Oh, it's a good cover, too. Let me find... we'll do it later. All right. Sorry. Sting, you're out. Well, till later anyways. Let's go ahead and play some Duran Duran. Why not? Since it's next. That one I do have. I just grabbed this. I heard it on the radio the other day, and I was like, that's a fun song. Let's pop this one in there, see what shakes loose. Again, hopefully my sheet music that I have here does match up with what I'm going to play. Here's Rio.
How 80s. Thank you. I'll let the saxophone do its thing for a second.
Okay, so that we're gonna have to fiddle with that one a little bit to get it. Okay, we're not going to play, but it's all right. All right. So before we go on, I need to wipe off some, you know, nice flops wet here. I apologize, but I hope you're enjoying this. Like I said, if you're new here, please pop a follow on there. That helps me. You know. Feel free to light up my comments, as I have not been watching the chat, but I can tell it is a little quiet in there. So, you know, pop a hi in there, you know, an emoji, emotional outburst, whatever you like. That's cool. And tell me what you think. So, as I said, what I'm doing today is I'm kind of going through some new music and seeing what I like and what I don't like. And, you know, what's going to work, what's not. This also is going to be music. I haven't done quartet arrangements of all of these. Some of them I have, but a couple of these I have not. So I want to give those a try. For sure. I want to try them with the quartet. Oh my gosh, I'm even getting sweat in my in-ear monitors and in my ears. Oh my gosh, it's so gross. Okay. Meanwhile, it's freezing cold outside. I'm in Atlanta, and it was like in the 70s yesterday, and then we get this big thunderstorm. And then, all of a sudden, it's now freezing cold again, which I love, by the way. I'm from Chicago. I like it when it's cold. I don't like it when it's warm. I prefer it to be cool, especially in the winter. I spent a lot of Christmases in Florida when my parents moved to Florida when they retired. And I hated it. I did not like spending Christmases in Florida. It wasn't fun. It just was weird. I mean, what was fun was playing golf on Christmas Day. That was fun, but to not, White Christmas is a thing that doesn't exist in a lot of places, even up north. You know, I lived in New Jersey for a long time, and it was rarely, I think in 25 years I lived in New Jersey, I could probably count on one hand how many actual white Christmases we had. I lived in Chicago many years, same thing. Although recently in the 2000, I think in 2009 or 10, we did have snow on Christmas. And we've had snow here in Atlanta on and around Christmas, I think, at least 1 year since I've been here. I've been here 10 years. So, gosh, that makes me... Just kidding. Not going to tell you. Anyways, we're going to play another Sting song here. Two in a row, actually. This next one is an old favorite of mine. From an album called Ten Summoner's Tales. which is interesting because that is Sting's given Christian name, Gordon Sumner. But this is a song called 7 Days, and it's a song that is in an odd meter. I don't know if any of you know anything about music, but if you know anything about music, you know that most rock and roll music is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And you clap and or snap on 2s and 4s, never on 1s and 3s. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. You know, you never on 1 and 3 because that's not allowed. Who just popped on here? Oh, my friend. Okay. My friend Julia is on now, which is a shame because she's better than me, and she's streaming right now. But we'll keep going. We're going to be done. We'll be done here in a minute anyways, but because I'm running out of energy, and I think I'm flop sweating all of my energy out of me right now. But I do want to get through a couple. I got 3 more new ones I want to get through, and then we'll see what happens after that. I do want to kind of fake my way through this Colin Hay song. We'll talk about that in a little while, but here's Sting, 7 Days. Thank you.
is the end. Okay, Jason, it's not your turn. All right.
God, I love that song. It's so much fun. I got to get the ending, though, right. Part of it is the weird meter, the 5 meter, kind of messes me up in terms of counting four, measure phrases, you know, and because that's what the whole thing of jazz and improvisational music anyway, which I'm terrible at, thank you very much, is that you're counting, you know, phrases. That's the way where, you know, that we talk about music is in phrases in a classical world. So we talk about 4-bar phrases or 8-bar phrases. In popular music, it's more like stanzas and verses. And there we go. I need to turn down my ear a little bit there. So like, you know, most songs have verses that are set in lines of 4. So you have, you know, she walked to the store, but it, and then something, and then she wanted a little more, and then something, something, something. So there's your 4 things, right? And then that's like 4, usually 2-bar or 4-bar phrases. And then you have like a, you might have a second little section like, and then she did the thing and she bought some flowers. But no, then she walked back home, down the thing. And then that's like you're back to the regular thing. That is, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, popular music explained without saying English words. Nevertheless, you have to count in your head those changes, those like the chord changes and the bar changes, so that you can you know, figure out, number one, what notes to play. You got to know what notes to play. That piece was easy. That song was easy because it's in C major. With some fancy, you know, C major, you know, with C major chords, C major 7 chords, C major 9 chords. But then some like, you know, C minor 9 chords, thrown in there, and, harmonically, not a difficult song. Some of Sting's songs can get very, very tricky, harmonically. Now this also is Sting. He wrote this, with Eric Clapton, and it was in a movie called Lethal Weapon 3, which was, let's be honest, not a great film, but was, this song is terrific. Lethal Weapon 3 was the beginning of, like, you know, the downhill, you know, of the Lethal Weapon movies. Word has it there is a 5. Lethal Weapon 5 that is going to happen. 3 was, you know, 1 and 2 were both fantastic. 1 was great. 2 was also great, but for different reasons. And then 3 was pretty good. And then 4 was like, okay, come on, guys, just stop. You know, but one good thing to come out of the 3rd movie, if nothing else, is this fantastic song. It's a very, more of a, like a laid back jazz. I dare not say smooth jazz. That's the most awful thing ever to happen to Western music. Thank you very much. There's a wonderful Venn diagram, actually, of that I've seen online where it's like, you know, it's a Venn diagram. So it's circles, and there's, you know, music is the big one circle, right? And then there's like jazz, and there's this jazz and that jazz, and they all intersect, and there's jazz that is smooth and that intersects. And then outside the big circle of music is smooth jazz. So, yeah, that's how that goes. But, you know, thank you to all of you who are here. If you are here and lurking, I appreciate it. These videos, I don't store videos on demand at Twitch. So if you want to see a stream that I have done, or most of a stream, usually I just edit out the, you know, the hours of me rambling on. But if you want to see me play some music that I played on stream, you can go ahead and watch it on YouTube. Chuck G Violin is my channel there. I hope you're noticing a theme here. I am Chuck G Violin everywhere. I even play, I play Apex Legends. I even play there as Chuck G Violin. So I play golf online also as Chuck G Violin. Madden, I don't. I don't remember what I did for Madden, but let's see, who's on now? Oh, Rachel Grace is on. Okay, Rachel's great too. I shouldn't be doing that because that is my competition, but she's not my competition. She's better than me. What can I say? Rachel Grace is terrific. Check her out if you haven't already. All right, what are we playing? We're playing It's Probably Me. This is by Sting and Eric Clapton, and is a great song. Enjoy.
Thank you.
great stuff there. Another fun and easy key to actually kind of jam out there in and improvise a little. That's E minor. I really enjoy playing that one. That one will get a front and center spot, that's for sure. That is Sting, Eric Clapton, It's Probably Me. Okay, one more new one we got coming up, which is an old favorite of mine, Sixpence None the Richer. Where are you at? Should be right around here because, let's see, JKL, right? Yep, okay. This has actually also been in a ton of movies, but it's a great song. It is called Kiss Me. So sorry. That is disgusting. I've been a little under the weather in case you didn't catch the beginning of the stream. Oh, dear. I have been experiencing a little bit of an upper respiratory infection. When I get sick, everything goes here into my chest because I am asthmatic. So that's a bummer for me. But, you know, that's just how it goes. This cold is kind of lingering on. Speaking of linger, I do have cranberries in here somewhere too. Zombie. Boy, that was a nice segue. Yeah. Anyways, I'll do that another time. I'm going to wrap it up because a couple of my favorites are streaming right now and I want to check them out. If you are lurking and want to see a good stream for some terrific violin music, check out Storiani Girl. That's my friend Julia, and I know her in real life. We used to work together at the Huntsville Symphony. She's a terrific, terrific violinist. When I say terrific, I mean, you know, like you think I play okay. She is so good. She's next level good. God tier good. And Rachel Grace is playing right now. I don't know her personally, but I do watch her stream. She's on right now, and so definitely check her out as well. And let's play some music. Let's play a little bit more of this, and we'll see what happens. This is another new one. I don't know if this is going to work or not. But we won't know until we try it, and we can't try it because it's not in here. Let me see if it's under. Holy crap, it's not in here. Well, that is disappointing. So let's find something else. All right, we're going to... This song, we're going to go ahead and do a song that I really, really like. And the name of this song is Waiting for My Real Life to Begin. And this is a song. Okay, come on now. Waiting for My Real Life to Begin. This is a song by a gentleman by the name of Colin Hay. And if you don't know who Colin Hay is, you should, because he's an amazing songwriter who used to be the frontman and lead singer of Men at Work. I kid you not. He used to be the lead singer of Men at Work. And I had accidentally stumbled on some of his music a long time ago. I used to watch a show on HBO called The Larry Sanders Show, starring the late, great Gary Shandling. And it was a kind of a behind-the-scenes type of show, kind of like 30 Rock was a behind-the-scenes Saturday Night Live show. And this was a behind-the-scenes kind of a Johnny Carson, David Letterman type of, you know, talk show with a big-time star. And he had all these guests on. And one of the musical guests one episode was Colin Hay. And I was like, I know that guy. That guy's from Men at Work. I love Men at Work. And he sang some great music. It was just him and acoustic guitar. And I was like, that's really nice. And then I never thought another thing about it until many years later. you know, I'm always looking for music. I like indie rock. I like indie acoustic folk rock the most. So when I stumble across, you know, a song like, you know, it's like something like from like Sarah Bareilles or what's the Sarah Michelson, whatever. you know, stuff like that. I get very excited. Passenger is another. I'm gonna get some Passenger music in here because I really like that music. But when I stumble across something like that, I like to go looking for this kind of music, and I went looking for some Colin Hay music after hearing some. Oh, that was right. I heard it on Coffee House on Sirius XM, and it was a song called "Send Somebody." And then another song by him was called Beautiful World. My, 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 it's a beautiful world. I like, I don't know. He likes lots of things. I like swimming in the sea. I like to go out beyond the white breakers where a man could be free, or a woman if you are one. That's how the song goes. Anyway, it's a great song. This song that I'm going to try to fake my way through is called Waiting for My Real Life to Begin. And it's a song that I didn't hear until I saw Colin Hay live here in Atlanta like 10 years ago. It was early 2013 I saw him. And I hadn't heard the song until then. And I was like, that song's great. And then I got listening to the words, which is something I don't usually do. I like or don't like music based on what the music sounds like. I don't like or not like music based on the words. If I liked or didn't like music based on the words, I wouldn't like the Smiths, you know, because those words, for the most part, are horrific. But I do like, you know, the Colin Hay was, this song, Waiting for My Real Life to Begin, was a song that really spoke to me because it reminded me of myself so much. You know, I keep saying to myself constantly, well, when I grow up, I'm going to be this, or I'm going to do this, or, you know, once I get going, man, this is how I'm going to be. But I don't ever do it, you know, and I don't get there, and I ignore the things that are happening to me now because I'm waiting for my real life to begin. And that's what this song is about. It's about, you know, there's great lines in there. Like, for example, the second verse is, when I woke today, suddenly nothing happened. But in my dreams, I slew the dragon. And down this beaten path and up the dusty trail, walking into my own footsteps once again. Basically, what he's saying is that, you know, he's not living his life. He's waiting for it to get going. Meanwhile, there's all these things happening that he didn't do. What was the third verse? He says, how does it start? I can sing the song in my head, but I can't remember how it's. Any minute now, my ship is coming in. I keep checking the horizon. I'll check my machine. There's sure to be that call. It's going to happen soon. Soon. Oh, so very soon. It's just that times are lean. But then he's interrupted by somebody. But you say, be still, my love. Open up your heart. Let the light shine through. And that's his loved one saying, hey, we're right here. Everything you want is here. You don't have to wait anymore. This is your life. This is what's happening right now. And it's a song that really spoke to me. You know, there are a few songs that have done that. This one is the most recent of them, and it has really stuck with me. I really, really love this song. Unfortunately, there's no sheet music for it anywhere. What I usually like to use is a piano, like piano vocal score, for all the music. That way I can see the chords, okay? And then I can, in seeing the chords, if there's no melody, then I can kind of make something up, you know, via the chords. But there is no sheet music for this, but I did find a backing track for it. So I'm going to try to kind of like fake my way through it as best I can. And let's get the headphones up, and we're going to see what happens. I love this song. This is called Waiting for My Real Life to Begin. This is by Colin Hay.
crashing. Thank you. Good stuff.
Oh, no, I didn't put my echo on for that one. Oh, well, that's my bad. Get these phones down. Okay. That is Waiting for My Real Life to Begin. I think I got it figured out for the most part. It's in a bad key. It's in B major. But that is a very big favorite of mine. I will play that just about every stream. The other song I play almost every single stream is What I Did for Love from Chorus Line. But I don't think I'm going to play that one right now. Well, maybe I am. Maybe I am. Hey, thanks so much, everyone, for coming out. I really appreciate it. No, you know what? We're going to play Bring Him Home instead. Because these are some of my favorites. So we're going to go ahead and do this. Let me get this one out of the queue. We played you. You're good. This is a song from Les Mis. Anybody who's watched any of my streams knows I play this quite a little bit. It's Andrew Lloyd Webber. This is called Bring Him Home. Thank you. Andrew Lloyd Webber, bring him home. Les Mis. Thank you so much for coming again. And everybody who came and lurked and saw me. I appreciate it. Every single one of you, if you were here for a minute, if you were here for an hour, if you were here for 5 minutes, I don't care. Hello, this is light that's supposed to be shining on me, but isn't. I do appreciate everybody who came by. I don't usually stream on Fridays, so this was a makeup from last night. Thanks so much for coming out. You all are terrific. I love each and every one of you, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks a lot.